Hello everyone. Good evening. Thank you very much for your attention to my English Japanese broadcast from Japan. Today is Sunday on the 1st May 2016 at 7:58 7 o'clock 58 at local Japan time. My name is Yasuhiko Yamazaki. I am a Japanese independent journalist based on internet media. I am also a political and social activist. I am broadcasting every day in Japanese, YY News Live, except Saturday and Wednesday at about 7 o'clock p.m.in local Japan time for more than 3 years and 8 months. I started English broadcast once a week on Sunday from the 7th February this year in order to talk directly to 1.4 billion of English speakers around the world to let them know the hidden and unknown truthon Japanese and the world. And the subject, main subject of tonight is there is a Showa Day, but why there is not a Meiji Day? Showa, it's the epoch of the Emperor Showa, and the Meiji epoch is the period of dominated by Emperor Meiji. And we have the national holiday on April 28th is celebrated.On the name of Showa Day, the origin of the name Showa Day is when Emperor Showa was living. This day was named.Celebrated his birthday of Showa, Emperor Showa. And after his death, the name was changed to Showa Day. ということで、皆さんこんばんは。YY ニュース山崎です。今日は2016年の5月の1日、今午後8時になりましたね。1時間ぐらい遅れました。申し訳ありません。I'm sorry to the delay of 1 hour. The English broadcast is scheduled to start at 7 o'clock in the evening, but today is 1 hour delayed. ということで今日のメインテーマは先週日本語放送の中でも取り上げましたけど、なぜ昭和の日があるのか、あるのに明治の日がないのかということですね。 So the subject tonight is there is a Showa Day, but why there is not a Meiji Day? The national holiday on April 28th of Showa Day was the Emperor Showa's birthday when he was alive. And after his death, the name was changed to Showa Day. So why was was the birthday of the Emperor Meiji on November 3rd?He was born in 1852, not the national holiday. And why does not the Meiji Day exist to celebrate? ということですね。で、4月28日は昭和天皇の誕生日だったものを昭和の日に名前を変えて、祝日にしたもんだと。じゃあなぜ明治天皇が誕生した11月3日1852年を明治の日に祝日にして祝わないのかという素朴な疑問ですね。And the American people celebrates every year on July 4th the independence of the United States of America in the national holiday. And the French people celebrate every day on July 14th the French Revolution in the national holiday. アメリカ国民は毎年7月4日を独立記念日として、祝日にして、祝うと。そして、フランス国民は7月14日を、フランス革命記念日として祝日にして、全国民で祝うということなんですよね。砂ズキンさんですね。Japanese and English bilingual broadcasting is being delivered now と。マリンさん、こんばんは。よろしくですね。Good evening ですね。日本語、英語、2カ国語放送、ただいま配信中と。Bilingual broadcast is now broadcasted.And Mr. 純一土山、he gives me almost all broadcast six teeth and two continue coins. Thank you very much. ですね。ということで、why ですね。なぜ昭和の日があって明治の日がないのかと。ということですね。If it is the original, the Japan also would celebrate the Meiji Restoration, which is written in the textbook as a revolution movement for the first time to the birth of the modern nation in Asia. But there is nothing about the Meiji Restoration anniversary day.Nor the Meiji Day celebrating the birth of the Meiji, Emperor Meiji. 本来であれば日本もアジアで初めて近代国家を誕生させた大変革運動として教科書に書かれている明治維新を国民が祝福するはずであると。でも実際は明治維新記念日の明治天皇誕生日の祝日がないのだと。これは一体何なのか。Why is the reason why?、What is the reason why? Because the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji hadn't rightfulness at all. なぜならば、明治維新も明治天皇も祝福するに値する正当性が全くなかったからだと。Because the dark secrets have been hidden.In the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji. なぜならば、明治維新と明治天皇には黒い秘密が隠されているとこういうことなんですね。ちょっとあれですね、画面がずれてましたね。 K さんです。エレファントムさんですね。コンティニューコインですね。If the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji became the national holiday to be celebrated by whole nation, the secret hidden in the middle Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji would be known throughout the nation. もしも明治維新や明治天皇を記念して全国民がお祝いをするということになれば、明治維新と明治天皇のに隠されていた秘密が全国民に知れ渡る危険性があるということで、日本支配階層は明治維新と明治 天皇を記念する祝日には絶対にしなかったんだと。Japanese dominating class have never commemorated the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji. マリンさんが打ち合わせね。マリンさん gave me 60ですね。5T ですか。エレファントムさん、コンティニューコンさん。So what was the secret of the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji? それでは明治天皇と明治維新の秘密は一体何なのかということですね。The Meiji Restoration was not a heartwarming story written in the textbook telling that many young samurais have uprised at the risk of lifeIn the fight to overthrow the Edo feudal system and that they have succeeded in setting up a first modern state in Asia, the young samurai in Asia ですね。明治維新は尊王攘夷の若い藩士たちが脱藩して江戸幕府を倒してアジアで初めて近代国家を打ち立てたという教科書に書かれているような美談では全くなかったんだとこういうことなんですね。The Meiji Restoration was a military coup d'état against Edo shogunate by four major feudal lords like as 長州、山口、薩摩、鹿児島、土佐、高知、and 肥後、佐賀、to whom the British government and the Jewish Rothschild International Financial Mafia having an aim of colonization of Japan after China have supported by financial aid, military aid, and strategy teaching.ということで、明治維新はアヘン戦争で中国を植民地化した英国政府とユダヤ・ロシアの国際金融マフィアがですね、日本を植民地にするために、薩長土肥の4つの外様大名に、財政援助、軍事援助、戦略指南をして起こした軍事クーデターだったということですね。In the main forces of the military coup d'état of the Meiji Restoration, there were four types of persons. The first type was the emperor entourage, like as Tomomi Iwakura.The second type was the young junior samurais of four major lords like as Takayoshi Kido, Takayoshi. The third type was the young samurais exiting the clan like as Ryoma Sakamoto. And the fourth type was the black people, discriminated people like as Hirobumi Ito, four times as Prime Minister after, and Toranosuke Omuro, Emperor Meiji after. The of village Tabuse, village ってフランス語か。The town of Tabuse.明治維新の軍事クーデターの主力は岩倉智美のような尊王攘夷派の天皇側近と木戸孝義や大久保利光などの薩長土肥の実権を握った下級藩士と坂本龍馬のような脱藩した下級武士とそして田伏村出身で後に明治天皇になった大室虎之助田伏出身で後に4回も首相になった伊藤博文や後の明治天皇になった 大室忠之助のような非差別部落民ということなんですね。それで岩倉具視、木戸孝允、伊藤博文らの軍事クーデター派は抗武合体の平和路線で体制変革を目指していた孔明天皇と嫡子の睦仁親王を邪魔となって暗殺したんだと。The three representatives of the forces of the military coup d'état, 具視、岩倉、孝允、木戸 and 博文、伊藤 have assassinated Emperor 孔明and his son, 睦仁 true emperor, 明治 because Emperor 孔明 was,who was aiming at regime change by peaceful route became their hindrance. 邪魔になったんですね。岩倉具視、木戸孝允、伊藤博文らの軍事クーデター代表クーデター派は、岩倉具視、木戸孝允、伊藤博文らに代表される軍事クーデター派は抗武合体の平和路線で体制変革を目指していた孔明天皇と嫡子の睦仁親王を邪魔となって暗殺した。And having assassinated son of Emperor 孔明、睦仁 at the age of 15 years, who was crowned the Emperor Meiji, they have replaced 睦仁 by 大室虎之助 of 15 years old, born in the Korean town of Tabuse of black people, discriminated people.He was disguised as Emperor Meiji. 明治天皇となった嫡子、睦仁親王も殺して、彼らは朝鮮部落出身の大村虎之助十四歳を差し替えて、明治天皇として偽装させたんだと。こういうことですね。万世一家というのは初代以降全部の天皇の誕生日を祝しすぎしなければならないです。そういうことですよね。何人いるんだということですよね。The royal imperial family is only one resource written in the constitution.That was created by 博文、伊藤 and executed in 1895, the Constitution of Meiji. In this constitution, the first一条ですね。The first, 何て言うんですか、article of the constitution, 博文、伊藤、wrote that the Japan was, is, and was dominated by the emperor of the unique.And only one source is. So if it was right, Mr. Tsunazuki-san, he said it would have to celebrate all the emperor.From the beginning to the Meiji. So with the text is over, so I will read the English text from the beginning to the end. There is a Showa Day, but why there is not a Meiji Day? The national holiday on April 28th of Showa Day was Emperor Showa's birthday when he was alive, and after his death, the name was changed to Showa Day. Why was the birthday of the Emperor Meiji on November 3rd? He was born in 1852, not the national holiday. And why does not the Meiji Day exist to celebrate? American people celebrate each year on July 4th, the independence of the United States of America, in the national holiday. And French people celebrate every year on July 14th, the French Revolution, in the national holiday. If it is the original, Japan also would celebrate the Meiji Restoration, which is written in the textbook as a revolutionary movement for the first time to the birth of the modern nation in Asia. But there is nothing about the Meiji Restoration Anniversary Day, nor the Meiji Day celebrating the birth of the Emperor Meiji. What is the reason why? Because the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji hadn't rightfulness at all, because the dark secret have been hidden in the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji. If the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji became the national holiday to be celebrated by whole nation, the secret hidden in the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji would be known throughout the nation. Japanese dominating class has never commemorated the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji. So what was the secret of the Meiji Restoration and Emperor Meiji? The Meiji Restoration was not a heartwarming story written in the textbook telling that many young samurais have uprised at the risk of life in the fight to overthrow the Edo feudal system, and that they have succeeded in setting up a first modern state in Asia. The Meiji Restoration was a military coup d'etat against Edo shogunate by four major feudal lords like Azu, Choshu, Yamaguchi, Satsuma, Kagoshima, Tosa, Koichi, and Higo Saga, to whom the British government and the Jewish Rothschild International Financial Mafia, having an aim of colonization of Japan after China by Opium War, have supported them, to whom? Supported by financial aid, military aid, and strategy teaching. And third, in the main forces of the military coup d'etat of Meiji Restoration, there were four types of persons. The first type was the emperor entourages, like as Tomomi Iwakura. The second type was the young junior samurais of four major lords, like as Takayoshi Kido. And the third type was the young samurai exiting the clan, like as Ryoma Sakamoto. The fourth type was the black people, discriminated people, like as Hironobu Ito, four times as prime minister after and Toranosuke Omuro, Emperor Meiji after, of town Tabuse. For the fourth reason, the three representatives of the forces of military coup d'etat, Tomomi Iwakura, Takayoshi Kido, and Hironobu Ito have assassinated Emperor Komei and his son Mutsuhito, true Emperor Meiji, because Emperor Komei, who was aiming at regime change by peaceful route, became their hindrance. Having assassinated the son of Emperor Komei Mutsuhito at the age of 15 years, who was crowned the Emperor Meiji, they have replaced Mutsuhito by Omuro Toranosuke of 15 years old, born in the Korean town of Tabuse, of black people, discriminated people. He was disguised as Emperor Meiji. And I will read the Japanese text from the beginning to the end. なぜ昭和の日があるのか、明治の日がないのか。4月28日は昭和天皇の誕生日だったものを昭和の日と名前を変えて祭日にしたものだが、なぜ明治天皇が誕生した11月3日、1852年生まれを明治の日の祝日にして祝わないのか。米国民は毎年7月4日、1776年を独立記念日にして祝日にして全国民で独立を祝っていると。またフランス国民は毎年7月14日をフランス革命記念日として祝日にして革命を全国民が祝っていると。本来であれば日本もアジアで初めて近代国家を誕生させた大変革運動と教科書に書かれている明治維新を全国民が祝福するはずであるが、明治維新記念日も明治天皇誕生日の祝日もないと。これは一体何なのかと。何故なのかと。なぜならば明治維新も明治天皇も祝福するほどに値する正当性が全くなかったからだと。明治維新と明治天皇には暗い秘密が隠されているからだと。もしも明治維新や明治天皇を祝日にして全国民がお祝いをするということになると、明治維新と明治天皇に隠されていた秘密が全国民に知れ渡る危険性があるので、日本支配階層は明治維新と明治天皇を記念する祝日には絶対にしなかったと。それでは明治維新と明治天皇の秘密とは一体何なのかと。1、2、3、4つですね。 There were four reasons why the Japanese dominating class have never commemorated the Meiji Restoration and the Emperor Meiji. なぜしなかったのか。一つ目、明治維新は尊王攘夷の若い藩士たちが脱藩して江戸幕府を倒してアジアで初めて近代国家を打ち立てたという教科書に書かれているような美談では全くなかったんだと。2番目、明治維新はアヘン戦争で中国を植民地化した英国政府と、英国政府を実質的に支配していたユダヤ・ロシアの国際金融マフィアが日本を植民地化する目的で江戸幕府に反抗していた薩長土肥の外様大名を支援して起こした軍事クーデターだと。支援が財政支援、軍事支援、そして戦略指南で。3つ目、明治維新の軍事クーデターの主力は岩倉具視のような尊王攘夷派の天皇側近と、木戸孝允や大久保利通などの薩長土肥の実権を握った下級武士たち、そして坂本龍馬のような脱藩した下級武士と、そして田伏村出身で4回も首相となった伊藤博文や、後の明治天皇となった大村虎之助のような非差別部落民だったんだと。 それで4番目、岩倉具視、木戸孝允、伊藤博文らに代表される軍事クーデターは、クーデター派は、公武合体の平和路線で体制変革を目指していた孝明天皇と嫡子睦仁を邪魔になって暗殺したの。で、明治天皇となった嫡子睦仁をも殺して、彼らは朝鮮部落出身の大村渡之助15歳に、明治天睦仁を差し替えて、その後明治天皇と偽装させたんだと。So there were, I talked about the four major reasons why the dominating class of Japan has never commemorated the Meiji restoration.Restoration and the Emperor Meiji、ということですね。ジャポンさんですか、お茶ですね。アイウネさん、ロシア時計は一族であるモーゼズ・モカッタ銀行を通してフランス革命への資金を提供したと、他の貴族資金提供もユダヤ人ということですね。ああ、アイウネさん、The family of Rothschild hasfinanced to the French Revolution by passing to the bank Moses Mokatta and the other supporter, financial supporters to the French Revolution wereThe Jewish ということですかね。ということは、The French Revolution was also financed by the family Rothschild. Rothschild が資金援助したということなんですね。だから彼ら、they have financed also to the、Russian Revolution. ロシア革命もそうですよね。And they have financed to the to colonize China by the Opium War. Jardine Matheson. It's a Rothschild family's trading company.Specialized in opium and the arms ですね。And young, young person of Jardine Matheson in Hong Kong, Mr. Glover, he was very young at time, 18th or 19th, 19 years old.He was sent to Japan to organize the coup d'etat to overthrow the Edo shogunate by the four major roads、ですね。だからグラバーもロシチャイドファミリーのいわゆる麻薬と武器取引の商社、ジャーディン・マセソンの香港支店から若いとですね、18か19の時に日本に派遣されたんですね。そして、日本を植民地化するために、江戸幕府 に、不満を持ってた薩長土肥の4つの藩に武器を提供すると。そして坂本龍馬等々を使って、薩長同盟を成功させて、近代兵器を与えて軍事訓練を施し、そして革命戦略を教えて、クーデターを起こさせるということですね。 フランス人権宣言、人間と市民の権利の宣言の絵の上の上部にピラミッドに万物を見ます。あ、またイルミナティ。あ、そうなんだ。シンボルマークが光ってんだ。すごいですね。フランス人権宣言ですよ。ちょっと明日のあれで、日本の放送の中で、I will show you the pyramid on the right of human declaration っていうんですかね、フランス人権宣言。Human rights celebration in French Revolution ですかね。The symbol mark of illuminate the human human eye ですね、左目ですね。Is illustrated on the human declaration of French Revolution。 同じやつが掲げられてるっていうのはすごいですね。The time is now 8:33 from the beginning, the time 36:39 was passed. I have 40 audience in the same time and at all 115 people audience.And I have 26 comments. And I have many comments and keys and continue comment. なんかどんどんあの秘密がつながってきますね。We have more than one secret hidden in the history of the family Rothschild and the revolution。 奥が深いですね。 The truth is hidden in the deep secret but now we are putting the light to the secret hidden in the darkness of the history of family Rothschild and revolution and all many criminality ですね。もう犯罪ですよね。 So thisToday's subject, today's English-Japanese broadcast is over. So thank you very much for your kind attention to my English-Japanese broadcast. And I will see you again tomorrow at about 7:00 in the local time, Japan times.In Japanese broadcast. So thank you very much and have a good night, good evening. Bye bye.